much for tuning in to another video. So as you can see, I have already washed my face and taken a shower, and I'm now actually applying a Cornhuskers lotion to my face. So what this is it's basically like a heavy duty hand cream, but I actually like to apply it to my face as a protective layer before I do any type of hair removal. And I am now actually taking my Nair facial hair cream and applying it to the spots that I want to get rid of the hair and just clean up my look a little bit. And then I go in with my concealer brush and I actually outline my eyebrows. So as you can see, I'm really going in really nice and close because I want to maintain that nice shape and getting really precise with that cream application. And then I just let it sit for 5 minutes and remove the cream and the hair comes right with it. And you just take a damp cloth of some sort and remove the cream. Now, the bottle says to take a damp towel. However, I like to use a damp cotton pad because I don't really love getting that stuff on my towels. So it's just a lot more convenient. So once I'm done with that, I take some toothpaste and I'm putting it on my lips just as an exfoliant. And I'm taking some essential oils, adding it to my lotion and just oiling up my skin right there. And now I am back. So now it's time to remove that Nair. And I'm taking that Nair, look at that hair that came with it. Yes! and it's going to have so nice and clean and just put together. It makes a big difference. Look at that arch, you guys. That arch is gorgeous. I do not go and get my brows waxed or threaded. This is how I arch my brows. And now, as you can see, I'm exfoliating my lips. I took a toothbrush and I'm just scrubbing, scrubbing, scrubbing. Kissable soft lips. Look at that. Gorgeous. Mwah! I love you guys. And then I'm taking my Olay oil minimizing facial toner and I'm toning my face. Make sure to get those ears, your neck, your shoulders, your décolleté, get it all. And then I'm going in with my La Mer treatment lotion, which is basically like a second toner, and I'm applying that to my skin. So I know I look like I'm being a little bit rough here, but it's kind of hard to get that stuff really on there because it's so liquidy. But I'm making sure I get it, and as you can see, I'm bringing it down. And I don't like get extra and put it on my neck or my shoulders or my décolleté. I just bring it down. And now I'm actually patting in my Elizabeth Charles 20% vitamin C complex. And that stuff is also pretty darn awesome. I do enjoy using it quite a bit. It's one of my favorite vitamin C serums. Not my favorite, but one of my favorite. And now I'm taking my Noni oil along with my Hydra Serum from Chanel and applying that to my skin. I mix 2 drops of Noni oil in with the Hydra Serum and it works wonderfully. It gives you a nice glow to your skin. And then now I am taking my Philosophy Take a Deep Breath Oxygenating Cream, gel cream, and applying it to my face, giving myself like a little facial massage here. Really making sure I work that nose. My nose tends to swell a lot, so if I give myself like a little nose massage as I'm putting my face cream on, it tends to like bring down and like make my nose look a lot smaller. So I do enjoy that. Now I'm taking my Rada Organics eye gel. I love this stuff, you guys. This is definitely a really good quality brand. They are not only organic, but this eye cream also has 18% vitamin C, plant peptides, and cucumber extract in it. And as you can see, I'm giving myself a little under eye massage. And what this is amazing for is it helps me look a lot less tired. And now I'm applying my Pharmacy Lavender Mint Lip Balm to my lips. Those sexy, sexy, kissable lips. And I'm just taking a moment to massage the rest of the cream that I had on my hand into my hands, actually. And now what I'm doing is I'm actually mixing 2 primers together. So I took my my Chanel illuminating primer and I blended it together with my professional primer. And then now I am actually blending foundations as well. So I'm taking my MAC NW43. I am NC45, but I like to use NW43 very often because I prefer the warmth of it. And I'm blending that together. My La Mer soft fluid in the color 20. And I'm just making sure that I blend it together enough that it gives me the right shade. And just kind of taking a moment to adjust as needed. And then now I'm just applying that foundation. Now I really prefer custom blending my foundation. I know a lot of people will say that it's too much work. But I will always ask for those little containers whenever I go and I buy product. So that I can take that extra few seconds and custom blend my foundation. Because I notice my skin is a little bit different in terms of shade every day. It changes, not drastically, but a little bit. And so a little bit goes a long way when you're talking about perfecting your skin in the look of how your foundation sits on your face. So really I recommend just asking, they won't say no, asking for a couple of those little containers when you like go to Nordstrom's or you go to Sephora, they'll give them to you. So now I am getting ready to go in with my, Naked Skin by Urban Decay. And I love this. It's like a salmon colored, color corrector. I'm taking my Tarte concealer, and this is the Amazonian clay concealer, and I'm applying it to the areas that I want it to be in, of course. Now this stuff I love. I don't understand, you guys. I've tried so many different concealers, and I've never found a concealer that I liked until I tried this one. Now I found some that I thought were okay. Honestly, I wouldn't even use concealer until I tried this concealer, and so that just goes to show you how much I like it. Now I'm taking my Laura Mercier Sunset Bronzing Crayon, and a little piece of it actually broke off, so I'm just using the tip that broke off. But this stuff is amazing. So it's not going to be as visible on me as it will be on a lot of other people because I am darker complexion, but I love it, and I'm putting it in just like an arc on my face, and it is amazing. It is like the best stuff ever. But I'm applying that to my face and really kind of contouring, doing a light contour with that first. And then I go in with my Chanel cream blush. So this Chanel cream blush is like a nice, I normally go for like the reds and the pinks in blushes, but this is such a nice blush, and it is like a really natural cream shade. I love it. And then I'm going in with my Clinique high impact mascara, and really building it up because I do not have a lot of lashes, you guys. Lashes are not one of the things that I was blessed with. So I'm really kind of going heavy with this mascara. I forgot to mention. So the Chanel blush, it is the, I'm going to say this wrong, I'm so sorry, Less Beige's Healthy Glow blush, and it is in color 21. And then I also use the Chanel lipstick, and I use the Rogue lipstick, and I don't remember what shade it is in. I will look later and add it into the description bar. But I'm now gone and just did a little bit more detail work with my contour and with my Revlon Brow Fantasy in dark brown, and I just use my e.l.f. Eyebrow gel, and going in now and applying the same Revlon Brow Fantasy pencil to my eyebrows because it is amazing, and then going in and just concealing the tops of my brows. So I went a little bit high on that one, but It's okay. And then I'm just going in and kind of touching up the ends of my brows, making sure that tail is nice and defined, because you really want to focus on the tail when you're doing your brows. And then I'm just setting with my Laura Mercier Sheer Candle Glow Perfecting Powder, because it is an amazing, amazing powder. It brings everything together. And then I'm going in really quick. I'm taking my little disposable nail files from Revlon and just giving myself a really quick, like 30 second file. Taking my Sensational I'm So Bordeaux Express Gel Polish and polishing my nails. And that is my light, my gel lamp. And that actually, the Express Polish cures in 30 seconds. So it takes you about 2 to 3 minutes to do your nails in total. And now I'm actually just starting to get dressed. As you can see, my outfit was already hanging on the door. And I'm moisturizing my hair. Don't mind those bobby pins in my mouth. I'm just moisturizing my hair and detangling and making sure to get all the knots out. I like to use the chase it method because it helps me to make sure there's no snarls. And I just put my hair up in a ponytail, into a high ponytail actually, and now I'm getting ready to twist my hair. So, and I actually had to take it down that time and redo it. But this I love, because you see that little bun? See how quickly that, like, I know it's fast forwarded, but you see how quick that hairstyle took, like, was, and it looks like I actually put effort in my hair, and I did not take a lot of time, you guys. It seemed like I took way more. So now I'm actually touching up my edges. I'm taking my, don't mind me, I just tripped over the chair. I forgot it was right there. So now I'm actually just taking my, Passion Fruit Control Paste by, yes, I'm using a makeup brush, but I didn't, I had a Tati moment, you guys. I'm just spritzing down my shoes and my hair, and then I'm taking some essential oils and putting on my feet and my pulse points, and I am good to go. Have a great day, y'all. Thank you so much for tuning in. Bye.